Did you know you can embed live video in PowerPoint? In this video, I will show you how to insert live video and apply the different settings. Let's get started. Called Cameo, this new feature rolled out to all Microsoft 365 users in the middle of 2022. To use Cameo, click the Insert tab and click the Cameo button on the far right. A video placeholder will appear in the bottom right-hand corner of the slide. In the ribbon, a new camera tab will appear. The default view is with the preview turned off, and you can click the small video icon to turn on preview or use the preview button in the camera tab. If you have more than one camera, the preview button will have a small drop-down arrow, and you can select the camera you want to use. The unique thing about this feature is that the video placeholder is an object, just like a shape, text box, or image. This allows you to make modifications that are not always possible in live streaming services like Zoom. First off, you can move the placeholder to a different spot on the slide. And then looking at the camera tab, you can see that there are several options to change the shape from the standard rectangle. If these options aren't exactly what you want, you can use the Change Shape dropdown and select any of the shapes from that menu. Other options include adding a border, and the Effects menu provides different settings for shadow, reflection, and glow. With the placeholder selected, you can resize it, and your video image will resize along with it. You can also crop the placeholder. This is great if you want to cut out unwanted background. If you like using the designer option, it can be used with the video placeholder added. Clicking the designer button will provide several different options for you to choose that are specific to Cameo and the video placeholder. I'd love to hear your thoughts about this new feature. In the comments section, let me know if you've used it and what you like and or dislike about it. The big thing to remember is that the video placeholder is unique to the individual slide. Any modifications you make will not be carried over to the next slide. Fortunately, you have a couple of options. If you haven't designed your overall slide deck, you can actually duplicate the slide from the thumbnail pane. The advantage here is that the placeholder will be in the exact same spot as all of the other slides. If you're adding the video placeholder as one of your last steps, you can copy the placeholder and paste it into the different slides. All of the settings, like the shape, shadow, etc., are preserved, and you can use the grid lines option to make your placement more concise if that is important. You can also create a template designed to include the video placeholder. When you're ready to present, you have a few options. Within the Microsoft ecosystem, you can use this option to present via Teams. You can also use this on a video streaming service like Zoom. Just remember to mute your video on the streaming platform. Continue watching for more design tips and strategies.